I'd like to thank the bishop.
Ningetaka nimshukuru askofu.
Through Pastor Alice.
Kupitia mchungaji Alice.
For giving me an opportunity to minister today.
Kwa kunipa nafasi ya kuhudumu siku ya leo.
It's nearly 30 years since I left this place to go to the United States.
Ni kama miaka 30 hivi tangu nilikotoka mahali hapa kwenda Marekani.
But by the grace of God we have remained connected. I keep coming back.
Lakini kwa neema yake Mwenyezi Mungu tumekuwa tumeunganishwa hivyo basi wanarudi.
And it's good that you know, if I had stayed for so long you didn't know when I'm growing old.
Na ni vizuri nikikaa sana utajua kwamba nimeendelea.
We have grown together. As you are growing old, I'm also growing old.
Jinsi unavyozidi kuzeka hata nami nazidi kuzeka.
You notice that every time maybe I come.
Na hivyo basi wewe unaliona jambo hilo kila wakati nikija.
I'm so happy to be back.
Na furahi sana kwa nimerudi.
And to enjoy the worship service.
Na kufurahia ibada.
You won't believe it, at some time I played the guitar and the keyboard.
Hauwezi ukaamini kwamba wakati mmoja nilikuwa nacheza gitaa na keyboard.
So I enjoy music a lot.
Na hivyo basi huwa nafurahia muziki sana.
To this day, so I enjoyed the worship service.
Na hivyo basi huwa nafurahia ibada ya siku.
I am the lead pastor of our church in the city of Memphis, Tennessee.
Mimi ndiye mchungaji mkuu katika jiji la Memphis.
It's coming to 4 years since I took the lead.
Ni miaka minne hivi tangu nilipochukua uongozi.
Yeah, the Lord has been very gracious for us in the last 4 years. I took it when the COVID was raging high.
Na Mungu amekuwa mwema kwetu sana miaka minne iliyopita na hasa wakati ambapo corona ilikuwa juu sana.
And by God's grace actually we received miracles, great financial miracles.
Na kwa neema yake Mwenyezi Mungu tukapokea miujiza wa kifedha.
That this year in March we were able to celebrate the full payment for our building.
Na kwamba mwezi wa tatu mwaka huu tuliweza kulipa gharama yote ya jengo letu.
So God is able to do things even at the wrong time, what you would call the wrong time.
Na hivyo basi Mungu anaweza akafanya mambo kwa muda mfupi yale ambayo tulifikia.
When I would never be able to push anybody to give more. Amen. When I would not be able to tell anybody to give more.
Wakati sitamwambia mtu yote atoe zaidi.
God did the heavy lifting.
Mungu alifanya kazi ambayo ilikuwa ni nzito.
Today's our text is taken from Ephesians chapter 10 verse 18.
Leo somo letu ni toka Efeso 10 sura 18.
Ephesians 6 verse 10 to 18.
Samahani wa Efeso 6 kuanzia mstari wa 10 hadi 18.
This is a text where the apostle Paul is writing to the church in Ephesus.
Ni Paulo alikuwa anaandikia kanisa la Efeso.
This is the last chapter in his letter.
Na hii ndio sura ya mwisho katika barua yake.
And he says in verse 10,
anasema kuanzia mstari wa 10.
Finally be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood. It is not against flesh and blood. It is not against physical beings and physical things. But against rulers, against authorities, against powers of this dark world, and against spiritual forces of evil in heavenly places. Therefore, put on the full armor of God. So that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And you have done everything to stand. Stand firm. Then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist. With the waist brace of righteousness in place. And with your feet fitted with readiness that comes from the gospel of peace.
Na miguu yako ikiwa imefungwa tokana na injili ya amani.
In addition to all this,
zaidi haya yote,
take up the shield of faith,
chukua ngao ya imani,
with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one.
Ambao uwezo kuzima mishale yote ya mwovu.
Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the spirit,
uvae chepeo ya wokovu na upanga wa roho,
which is the word of God.
Ambao ni neno lake Mwenyezi Mungu.
Verse 18.
Sura 18.
And pray in the Spirit on all occasions.
Na uombe katika roho kila wakati.
With all kinds of prayers and requests.
Na maombi aina yote.
With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all God's people.
Ukikumbuka kuwa makini na uombee watu wote wa Mungu.
This text in Ephesians chapter 6.
Haya maandiko katika Efeso 6.
Can be read together with the chapter 1 of Joshua. Some Bible scholars say Ephesians is Joshua in the New Testament. Because it speaks of spiritual warfare. It speaks about where you have the promise and there is a possession over there. Both of them speak about how you move from where you receive the promise to where you actually take possession of that promise. You find echoes of these texts that we read in Joshua chapter 1. Where in Joshua chapter 1 verse 3 to 6, the Bible says, I will give you every place where you set your foot. As I promised. And he gives the geography of the territory that he has given. And then verse 5. He says, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous. Remember what he said in Ephesians, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And here Joshua is being told, be strong and courageous. Why? Because you will lead these people to inherit the land I sowed to their ancestors to give them. As I said, the book of Joshua and the book of Ephesians teach us about spiritual warfare. In Ephesians, the Bible says, the struggle. There is a struggle between where we have given the promise and the time we take possession of it. There are forces that are trying to stop us from getting the blessing that God has for us. And we see a physical picture, a graphic picture with the children of Israel. That when God promised them, it was an actual promise that was even physical boundaries. And yet here they are. Between where they were and to reach there, there were many things that would stop them. There were enemies. And there were physical elements. The Bible says, he told them, even if I give you the land right now, you will not be able to manage it. You do not have the capacity. So there is something happening between when you receive the promise of God and when you actually come into possession. The Bible says, God has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. He has given us a promise for all that we need. But it is a promise. We still need to go and possess it. And that is what Paul is talking about here in chapter 6. He's saying from chapter 1, I was telling you about the promises of God. I was telling you of the great heritage that we have in God. Indeed, in chapter 1 of Ephesians, the Paul is saying, I'm praying for you for your eyes to be opened. That you might even be able to see the great blessings that we have in God. The great blessings that you have in God by your connection with God. So there is no question that God has blessings for us. But there is a struggle. There is a process between where we are and where we receive. And that's where Paul wants to help us. He's saying, finally, of all these that I've told you, if you are going to get to those blessings that God has for you, you have to be strong. You have to be strong. You have to be strong for yourself, as God told Joshua, and for others who look to you. If you are head of a family, you have to be strong for yourself and for your family, because you are going to help them to catch their blessings. You are going to help them to catch the promises of God. You have to be strong. You have to be strong. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. There are two sides to this preparation or as you enter into this struggle and this warfare. There is a spiritual side. And many times we emphasize the spiritual side of the warfare. But you can see these people, the children of Israel, if they stayed all the time in Karura Forest, if they stayed in Karura Forest praying, and they prayed and they went to the prayer caves, they still needed to take steps. So spiritual warfare has both the spiritual. You have to be prepared spiritually. But there is still the physical part. Where you are yourself, you have to move towards the blessings of God. And that's why Jesus said in Matthew 7:7, walk on your feet and knock doors. Knock on your feet and ask questions. Walk on your feet and seek the answers that you want. And as you walk forward, because you are already equipped by God, you will find that doors will start moving out. So there is always these two sides to a spiritual warfare. You have to be equipped spiritually. You have to be equipped spiritually, but you have also to take a step of faith. We see a very simple example in David. David said, I am ready and I'm coming in the name of the Lord. And he started taking a step towards the enemy, the giant. So he was coming in the power of the Lord. But he had to move towards the enemy. He had to use something physical as a point of contact. So we see in spiritual warfare, there is a spiritual preparation. We can see David was already prepared. That's why he's saying, I'm coming in the name of the Lord. I'm coming equipped by the Lord. And he rejected the armor of the king because he had been already armed by God. So there is always these two sides where we are asking for God to arm us, but we still have to face the enemy. You have still got to knock doors. You got to still connect with other people. You still got to ask questions. And that's why you must remain connected. Because God works through people. Amen.
Amen.
Anybody who doesn't belong to one of the home groups, raise your hand so that I pray for you. Raise your hand so I pray for you. You need to remain connected. Because God works through people. After you are prayed in the forest, you still got to get out. And you still got to get out. After you are prayed, and you are spiritually equipped, you still got to get into the outside world. And move towards what God has promised you. I don't know, maybe I'm speaking in a language which is, what do they call it? A fake American accent. Maybe that's why you but after having stayed in a place for 28 years, you are likely to start speaking in a fake accent, whatever place it is. So maybe that's why I'm kind of... yeah, but after you have prayed, you got to go face Goliath. You can't run away from him. You got to be there. You got to face him. Yeah, we would like God to send him away quickly. To God to swallow him out. God to blow him out with the wind. But that's not the way it works. God always wants to use us. So that we can also be part of what God is doing. Amen.
Amen.
So there are certain things that you learn very quickly from these two texts. That the promises of God are yes and amen. You can see even in the case of the children, he actually gave them the beacons. So there was no doubt about the promise. The inheritance is guaranteed. But what is also true, that there is a process between the promise and possession. There is a need to be prepared before you even go into that journey. And to go through that journey, you have to be strong and courageous. But the good thing, it is not your strength or my strength. It is the strength of the Lord. Because in our own strength, we cannot be able to defeat the forces of evil. And that's why Paul is saying, be strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. There is nothing of yours in that one. You want to be strong in the Lord. In the power of the Lord. And he told Joshua, nobody will be able to withstand you. Because I will be with you. So if there is that strength in the Lord, that strong bond of connection, you are tight with the Lord, then you can go in his power. You have a strong bond with him. You are strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. In the use of his weapons. That's what he's telling us. Your connection with God has to be tight. And you must use the weapons of God. Writing to the Corinthians, he says, our weapons are not human. They are not made of They are not of physical weapons.
Silaha zetu si za kimaumbile ya binadamu.
They are mighty in God.
Zina nguvu katika Bwana.
And they are able to pull down strongholds.
Na zinaweza zikaangusha ngome zote.
So stop fighting people.
Na hivyo basi wacha kupigana na watu.
Because if you, even when you see people fighting you,
kwa sababu kiona watu wanapigana nawe,
it is not them.
Sio hao.
It is the powers of darkness
giza,
that are using people against you.
Ambazo zinatumia
just
watu
the same
kinyamu.
Way God uses people
jinsi ambavyo Mungu naye hutumia
to
watu.
Bring blessings to you,
ili
to be destiny connectors.
Ili
there are people sent by the enemy to you
pana watu amba uleto na adu
to distract you from your destiny.
Ili wakuondoe katika hatima yako.
I look at one young person.
Nilimwangalia kijana moja.
And when I saw the company that they were with,
na nilipoona watu ambao wanatembea nao,
I realized, oh, it is not only destiny connectors. You can have people actually who are leading you to hell. So it depends on who you are connecting with. Someone can be a destiny connector or can be a connector to hell. So we choose our company as well. Because whatever we choose helps us to go where we are going.
Amen.
Not in your power, not in mine. Strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. So we can see quickly that when the promise is given, the possession of that promise is not automatic. When the children of Israel received the promise, they had still got to go to it. The only time they stayed where they are and received something is when they got manna. All other time, they had to step out and do something. So sometimes when you are completely flat, God can still send you manna.
Mungu bado anaweza akakutumia mara.
But in most other times,
lakini mara nyingi,
he wants you to step out.
Angetaka utembee.
After you have prayed,
baada ya kuomba,
then you step out.
Utoke.
And then you can see you can go in the power of the Lord.
Ili utembee katika nguvu zake Mwenyezi Mungu.
Although it looks difficult, it's not difficult.
Japo kuwa huonekana kama ni ngumu, si ngumu.
Because it is not in your power or mine.
Si kwa nguvu zako ama zangu.
It is in the power of the Lord.
Ni kwa nguvu zake Bwana.
Without God,
bila Mungu,
we can be easily blocked from our blessings.
Tuweza tukazuiliwa toka kwenye baraka zetu.
We can see the blessings out there.
Waweza ukaziona ndizo zile baraka.
But without God, we can be very easily blocked. The only power that can withstand the powers of darkness is the power of God. Yes, God has given us promises. But alas, we still need his help. To fully get into his storehouse and take what we need. You might say that's unfair. Why would God promise me and then make it very difficult for me to receive the blessings? But isn't that what we do? If you have your own organization or business, you go to the university, you select those who have passed very well, and you make them management trainees. They can see the big office where they will finally sit. That is a promise. But you put them through a process. You show them that is the office where you will sit. But you sit in the hall. Learn everything that everybody is doing. So we do it even we ourselves. We train people, we equip them. And that is what Paul is talking about. He says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. That's what we do. We equip our anyone who we want to train. We build capacity on them. As I said, the children of Israel were told, I'm not going to give you the whole land at once. Because even if I give it to you, the weeds will grow and you will not be able to take care of the land. Until you build capacity, then I'll continue giving it bit by bit. And that's what God is doing to you and me. As you build capacity and ability to handle his blessings, you find that he is causing you to grow. And what would happen if you are not building capacity? What will happen? Is he going to give you the other land? I leave it to you to answer that. He wants us to be prepared and equipped for the blessings ahead. And he wants us to know that there are barriers ahead of us. He wants us to know that there are evils that hang on the way to derail us. That is what he is calling them, powers and principalities. All kinds of powerful evil forces which oppose God and his people. As I said, they are not physical forces. These are spiritual forces that we war against. But our weapons are mighty in God. That we are able to pull these weapons of the enemy down through the power of God. As I said, you have to be strong for yourself and for others. We are just finishing the study of the book of Galatians in our city. We have a citywide Bible study which is attended by Zoom, by people across the country, actually. And we are just finishing studying the book of Galatians. And as we were looking at chapter 6 of Galatians, the Apostle Paul almost says in the same breath, carry one another's burdens. And then before he finishes, he says, you must carry your own load.
So
we were wondering, is the apostle talking from both sides of the mouth?
But
we realized, you have to be strong yourself. Although there are many people who will help you, really, what will carry you is the strength you have built in yourself. I will help you. I will pray with you a bit. But really, if you want to be strong in the Lord, you have to pray yourself through. So the apostle was not confused. He was saying, let's help one another. But everyone will have to carry their own load. Kila mtu lazima abebe mzigo wake mwenyewe. Although we help one another. And that's what Paul is telling us. You have to be strong yourself in the Lord. You see what is being popular preaching these days. Someone is telling you, I've been praying for the whole week. Come, I help you. But I want to tell you. Yes, someone can pray for you. But you need to be strong in the Lord. You need to be able to go through to the Holy of Holies. That is why the curtain of the temple was pierced twice. That you can go yourself. That you don't have to wait for an apostle. You don't have to wait for a pastor. You don't have to wait for me. Yes, I will help you. But you must carry your own load. Amen.
Amen.
Otherwise, someone will tell you have no time to pray. You have no time to pray. I have the time.
Nina wakati.
Give me the envelope.
Nipe bahasha.
I will be praying for you. You can do other things.
Nitakuwa na kuombea na utafanya.
But that is not going to help you.
Amen.
That's not going to help you. And I want to pray that nobody is caught up in this kind of thing. Where you are depending on somebody else. You must carry your own weight. You must carry your own load. You have to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. So that even when I'm coming to pray with you, you are already praying. I'm just coming to back you. I'm just coming to join you. Amen?
Amen.
This is a bad preacher. I want you to be free in the Lord. He says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Be strong in your connection with Him. And be strong in the use of the weapons that He provides. So because Paul wants to teach us, he's giving us a picture of a Roman soldier. And he says, like a soldier, put on the whole armor of God. All the pieces. All the pieces of the armor that make a soldier secure and well equipped
salama
to face the enemy.
Amen.
You don't face the enemy just like that. You have to be equipped, he says, be fully equipped with all the pieces of the armor. We have to remain fully equipped with the armor of God. And he breaks down the pieces of the armor. And he starts with the one of the pieces. He says, put on the belt of truth. This soldier who is going to face the enemy must put on the belt of truth. You see, the belt, like where I live, the any law enforcement person, like the police, the belt,
mshipi,
on the belt, there is so much equipment, you wonder how he's able to walk. It's unlike here, you find the belt doesn't have much. But in some places you go, the belt has got the gun. It has the electric taser, he points to you and it touches you and you Amen. You fall down. Amen. It might have the pepper spray he sprays on you and you are blinded. Amen. It might have a torch.
Yes,
and two sets of handcuffs.
Na pingu mbili.
So the belt is actually so heavy, you actually wonder, how is this guy able to walk actually? Because you think it'll pull him down.
Mshipi huwa ni mzito sana, unashangaa.
So the belt holds everything together.
Hivo, mshipi hushika kila kitu pamoja.
For a soldier,
kwa mwanajeshi,
the belt holds everything together.
Mshipi hushika kila kitu.
And he says, put on the belt of truth.
Na anasema vaeni mshipi wa
kweli. So for every Christian, truth holds everything.
Kwa kila Kristo ukweli hushikilia.
If you have problems with the truth,
kama una shida na ukweli,
everything will fall apart.
Kila kitu kitaanguka.
The belt of truth.
Mshipi wa ukweli.
Honesty and sincerity.
Kusema ukweli.
A commitment to a life of integrity.
Kujitolea kwa maisha.
That is holds the soldier ready for fight.
Dicho ambacho humweka askari akiwa tayari kwa vita.
If you do not have the belt of truth,
kama huna mshipi wa kweli,
the devil will laugh at you.
Shetani atakuchekelea.
Because he is the father of lies.
Kwa sababu yeye ndiye baba wa uongo.
He says you are one of us.
Anasema wewe ni mmoja wetu.
You tell lies just like us.
Wewe unasema uongo kama sisi.
When you have the belt of truth,
lakini ukiwa na mshipi wa kweli,
it repels the devil like the way you spray mosquitoes.
Wewe unatorosha.
Because he is the father of lies.
Kwa sababu yeye ndiye.
So when you spray the truth,
na hivyo ukipiga manasho,
all the devils run away.
Shetani huwa anatoroka.
The belt of truth. A commitment to a life of integrity. If you live a life of integrity, you never look behind you to see whether there is somebody following you. Because even if they follow you, they find your life is clean. The belt of truth. That soldier who is going to face the enemy. That soldier who is going to be strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. Is now being equipped. Is now being prepared. And one of the pieces, the beginning piece, is the belt of truth. A commitment to honesty, to integrity, and God's unchanging standards. Jesus said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If you have the belt of truth, you have received the freedom that comes from the gospel. Amen?
Amen.
And Jesus, talking to the Samaritan woman, told her, you are talking of your church where you pray. You are talking of how you pray in your denomination. He said, a time is coming. The Lord is not going to be concerned about the place and the manner. But he will be looking for those who worship him in spirit and truth. The belt of truth. It doesn't matter which church. Even the best church, if you are not wearing the belt of truth, then the Lord is saying, I'm looking for those who shall worship in spirit. The truth is a weapon. As a weapon, the truth is going to chase the darkness away. Truth is light. It sheds light to the darkness and chases it away. The apostle tells us, put on the whole armor of God, all the pieces. The second piece, he says, put on the breastplate of righteousness. The bulletproof vest. To protect the vital part, the heart. The breastplate of righteousness. It's bulletproof. Yes. The Lord has provided us with the breastplate of righteousness. When Jesus died, God looking at us, those who have received Jesus, when God looks at you, He sees you through Jesus.
Anakuona kupitia Yesu.
And you are justified.
Na unawekwa
haki. He sees you as though you have never sinned.
Anakuona ni kama hujaifanya dhambi.
He has clothed you with righteousness.
Na amekuvika utakatifu.
To justify is a legal term.
Kwa haki ni neno la kisheria.
It doesn't mean that you have never done anything wrong.
Haimaanishi kwamba hujaikosea.
But you have come to a place where your debts and your wrongs have been cancelled.
Lakini umefika mahali
they have been forgiven.
Zimesamehewa.
Yes, you had done wrong.
Ni kweli ulikuwa umekosea.
But now you are free.
Lakini sasa uko.
But now you have been forgiven.
Umeshasamehewa.
It is like a bulletproof vest.
Ni kama vazi ambalo uzi.
Satan will come and accuse you of the bad things you did.
Kwamba shetani atakuja kukustaki.
But when he strikes you, you have a bulletproof vest.
Lakini akikuangalia ataona kwamba
because it is given by God. Your salvation is a free gift by God you received by faith.
Kwa sababu wokovu wako ni kipawa cha bure ulichopokea.
But you have to wear it so that the enemy is not going to keep accusing you and causing you to doubt yourself.
Naweza kuvaa ili adui asiwe na.
So as you now face the enemy.
Hivyo basi unapokabili adui.
As a soldier of Christ.
Kama askari wa Yesu.
Strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Ukiwa na imara katika.
You are wearing a bulletproof vest.
Ukiwa umevaa diri yako.
That whenever the enemy comes and he says, "Oh, remember what you did several years ago."
Adui akija na kukumbusha kumbuka ulipofanya.
You just put your chest out.
Huo unatoa tu kifua.
And he can see the bulletproof vest.
Na anaweza kaona diri.
Because it's been given by God.
Kwa sababu
God has forgiven you.
Ushasamehewa.
And now you are a free person.
Na sasa uko huru.
You see, as a weapon,
kama silaha,
that assurance that we have,
hilo hakikisho pale tuko.
Closes away
huwa inafunga
doubts and discouragement.
Kushushwa moyo.
Then Paul says, put on the shoes of the gospel of peace.
Alafu Paul anasema vaa viatu vya injili ya amani.
You see, to a soldier,
kama wewe ni askari,
the shoes are for protecting the feet.
Viatu ni vya kukinga miguu yako.
And to provide stability.
Na huwa inakupa uweze kusimama.
So he says put on the shoes of the gospel of peace.
Na hivyo basi anasema vaeni viatu vya injili.
So the gospel has brought stability in our lives.
Na hivyo basi injili imeleta kuweza kusimama vizuri katika maisha.
In a confused world.
Katika
in a world where people just running to and fro.
Dunia ambapo watu
wana. When you receive the gospel.
Ukipokea injili.
It the first thing it brings into your life.
Jambo la kwanza ambalo unataka kusema.
Is calmness. It causes you to calm down.
Inakuwezesha ili uwe umetulia.
It brings stability.
Huwa inakuleta inakupa msimamo.
Because without stability,
kwa sababu bila msimamo thabiti,
you can't do anything.
Hauwezi kufanya.
That's the first thing we teach children in kindergarten.
Amen.
To settle down.
Amen.
To be still.
Ndio sababu huwa tunawafunza watoto.
And that's what the gospel does to us. It calms us down.
Huwa inatutuliza.
It gives us stability. The gospel gives us stability. Just like the shoes of the soldier.
Jinsi viatu vyako vinavyo
the gospel of peace.
Injili ya amani.
As a weapon.
Kama silaha.
The feet are for protection. The shoes are for protecting.
Viatu ni vya kukulinda.
The gospel of peace.
Injili ya amani.
Is protection. It shows us the boundaries.
Huwa ni ulinzi ambao unatuonyesha mipaka.
Of where it's safe and where it is not safe.
Mahali ambapo ni salama na mahali ambapo si salama.
So if the shoes were protection for the soldier's feet and providing stability.
Kama viatu vilikuwa ni vya kukinga miguu.
The gospel which is being compared to the shoes.
Injili ambayo inalinganishwa na viatu.
It brings stability into our lives.
Huwa inaleta msimamo thabiti.
It helps us to know the boundaries.
Utusaidia tujue mipaka.
Of where the dangers are and where the dangers are not.
Mahali kuna hatari na mahali ambapo hakuna hatari.
You see, the Bible compares humans to sheep.
Biblia inatulinganisha na kondoo.
Now I don't want you to say the Bible is being rude.
Sitaki useme kwamba Biblia haisemi vizuri.
But you know, if you have read the Bible compares us to sheep.
Lakini kama umesoma Biblia unajua kwamba huwa inatulinganisha na kondoo.
Not the kind of thing you would like anybody to call you.
Si jina ambalo ungependa mtu yote akuite.
But then that is the Bible. What do we do?
Lakini hiyo ndio Biblia.
But when you reflect why God would say that.
Lakini ukitafakari kwa nini Mungu anasema hivyo.
It is because we are so easily misled.
Ni kwa sababu huwa tunapotoshwa.
And we are very easy to mislead ourselves.
Na hata sisi wenyewe huwa tunajipotosha kwa urahisi.
So whenever you see the word sheep in the Bible, don't get annoyed. It just reminds you how vulnerable you are to being misled and to misleading yourself. And that's why we need the gospel of God. To even help us see the boundaries of where the dangers are. And those who read the scriptures, you find in situations where you don't know what to do, the word of God will come to you and it will help you to make a decision. Because you might find you have stepped too far into danger. The gospel of peace helps us to get ready to serve God and others, giving our lives purpose and meaning. And last he says, at all times carry faith as a shield. Other translation says, above all, taking the shield of faith. You see, the shield, the Bible says, it is going to quench, to stop every arrow that the enemy is going to throw to you. You see, unlike the breastplate, the shield, you can move it around. So whenever the arrow is coming from, you are able to move the shield around. What does that really mean? It means you can use your faith in every situation. And in every situation when you are attacked by the enemy, use faith to disarm, to quench every weapon, every weapon of doubt, every weapon of discouragement, everything that would make you doubt God. You see, faith, you can use it anywhere. Whatever comes your way, you tell it, I trust God. When Paul was in a shipwreck, and everything looked like it's going to perish, including him and the other passengers, he stood up and uttered these words, I believe God. And that is what Paul is telling us here again. That in every situation, whatever it is, you can stand up and face it, look at it on the face, and tell the situation, I believe God. I believe God. That he knows a way even where it seems there is no way. When it looks they were going to perish, him and the other passengers, and everything that was in the boat, he stood up and said, I believe God. So faith is a shield. Your faith, even when you are falsely accused, when you don't know, how can I even try to explain that I was not in that place? Everybody saying he's the one. You just say, I believe God. And someone will come from somewhere. Say, he is not the one. She is not the one who did that. Faith as a shield. Everywhere you go, take the shield of faith. You are trusting God. I have one more minute. You see, faith as a weapon.
Imani kama silaha.
It keeps hope alive.
Huwa inasoma.
Faith keeps hope alive.
Oh, imani huweka tumaini juu.
Faith is the evidence of things hoped for.
Imani ni ushahidi wa mambo ambayo tunatumainia.
Faith keeps hope alive.
Na huwa inaweka.
That is what causes endurance in you.
Ndivyo Paulo anavyosema.
Your faith, because it keeps that hope you have.
Kwamba imani yako huweka tumaini.
Alive. And you are able to endure the circumstances of today.
ukahimili hali leo.
As I come to the to conclude,
napomalizi.
He says, put on the helmet of salvation.
Yasema va chepeo ya wokovu.
The helmet protects the head and the mind,
ambayo huwa inakinga kichwa na
which are the vital organs, the engine that drives the rest of the person.
Ambavyo ni viungo muhimu sana vinavyodhibiti mambo mengine ya binadamu.
Most of the battles we find are in our minds.
Vita vingi ambavyo tunakumbana navyo huwa kwenye mawazo yetu.
The mind needs to be protected and secured.
Na hivyo basi lazima mawazo yalindwe.
The helmet of salvation. The assurance of salvation. It keeps our minds secure in God. And we can therefore stand on the word of God. And then he tells us about the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Most of the other weapons that the soldier puts on are defensive. But here he tells us you have an offensive weapon. The word of God is a sword. You can attack the enemy with it. The word of God is a sword. As a weapon. Whenever, whatever comes our way, by way of attack, you can refer to the word of God. And the word of God will give advice, and it will give you assurance. So you are able to attack anything that comes your way. The word of God, as a sword, it can attack and demolish everything that raises itself against the knowledge of Christ. Anything that raises itself contrary to the word of God. I hear there is a new awakening of culture in this country. I hear people are revisiting the cultures of old. And as we discuss the book of Galatians in our Bible study, which also discusses that subject, because the question raised in that book is, shall the new Christians follow the traditions of the Jews? So it touches on culture. And the conclusion we came to is culture is good so long as it is not contrary to the word of God. So whenever people call you for these cultural things, let the word of God be your sword to bring down anything that is contrary to the word of God. All culture is good as long as it is not contrary to the word of God. That is a simple rule of thumb. All culture is good as long as it is not contrary to the word of God. Because as a weapon, the word of God is able to help us to cut through deception. It is able to help us to cut through the clutter. It is able to help us to clarify the issues of life. And verse 18, the last verse, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayer and requests. All prayers and requests. After putting on the whole armor, all the pieces, all the weapons, you are now ready. Now plug in by prayer to the power source, which is God. Now you are fully equipped and well connected to the power source, and you can face the enemy. Prayer is the fuel. It's the fuel, the petrol, the fuel that keeps the weapons forward. It is not the It is not the weapons that they make the soldier powerful.
Si silaha ambazo hufanya askari awe mwenye nguvu.
Please remember that as I finish.
Kumbuka hilo unapomaliza.
It is not the weapons that make the soldier powerful.
Si silaha ambazo hufanya askari awe mwenye nguvu.
And I want to give you an example which you will never forget.
Na nitakupa mfano ambao hutasahau.
Imagine you are driving an 18-wheeler truck.
Fikiria kwamba unaendesha lori kubwa.
You know the truck which is a truck and it has another truck is pulling. A big truck. And it's one truck and it's also pulling another on a trailer.
Pana lori ambalo huwa na trailer.
And it's driving along Thika Highway.
Na unaendesha pale kwenye barabara ya Thika.
And a small lady.
Na binti ndogo.
In a police uniform.
Akiwa na vazi lake askari.
She does like this. She points to the side of the road.
Anakuonyesha wingie pembeni.
Do you think it is the uniform that makes the lorry to stop and go to the side? It is the power behind that little lady. You can defy her. But Big Brother will find you wherever you go. So it is not our outside stature that matters. It's not the way we look that matters. But the power behind us. And that's why we can, in the name of Jesus, because we are connected to God, we can use the name of God to demolish powers and principalities. We can tell the devil off our families. We can command the devil off our jobs. We can command the devil off whatever concerns us. Like that little lady, we are telling the truth. Track, get off the road. It doesn't matter how small you look. Amen. The power, your finger is powered by God.
Amen.
You are able to command the powers and principalities to stop messing up with God's people. To stop messing up with your family.
Amen.
To stop messing up with your business.
Amen.
You are able to use the power of God. The weapons that the soldier is putting on. It's just to get you ready to go to work.
Amen.
And then you connect to the power source.
Ujunganisha.
And you are ready to do exploits.
Naweza ukafanya mambo makuu.
Let us pray. As we come to prayer now,
tunapokuja kwa maombi,
fully armed,
tukiwa na silaha zote,
let us address those major issues in your life and mine by connecting to God in prayer. Let us use the name of Jesus to dismantle the works of the enemy. Yes, I want to tell you, address that issue by name. That mountain, that challenge, whatever it is, whatever big issue you are facing, you are an armed soldier. Use the authority of the one who has you are connected with. The power of God. The name of Jesus. I want it in your own voice. To speak to whatever it is. Call it by name. And tell it, I command you to stop in Jesus' name. I command you to cease and desist. From messing up with my job. From messing up with my family. From messing up with my body. From messing up with whatever concerns me. You know what it is. Whatever in your life you are facing as a challenge.
Amen.
Tell it, call it by name. And tell it in the name of Jesus. To cease and desist. To stop. And now in the name of the Lord. I stand in this order. And pray that the power of God will back every prayer. Whatever petitions that have been made by your people, I pray that, Lord, you honor those prayers. I command the powers of the enemy, powers and principalities and dark forces which oppose God and his people. I come against them in the name of Jesus. I demolish them. Everything that exalts itself above the knowledge of God, everything that opposes the word of God, I command it to cease and to desist. I bring it down in the name of Jesus. I bring those forces down. Everyone under my voice, I pray that the power of God will touch you, strengthen you, and cause you to walk in the strength of the Lord, and cause you to walk in the victory of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, because you hear us. We thank you because you have encouraged us that we should have a strong bond with you and use the weapons that you have given us. We thank you, Lord. Let's give the Lord a handcuff offering for his good. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Amen.